Let's talk about standardizing normally distributed random variables. Suppose X is a normally distributed random variable with mean, mu, and standard deviation sigma, which we sometimes write, notation-wise, as X is distributed normally with a mean of mu and a variance of sigma squared. This is not universal notation, but it is pretty standard. X is distributed normally with a mean of mu, and the second term is the variance sigma squared. And a standard deviation of sigma, of course. Now suppose we want to standardize this. In other words, turn it into something that has a standard normal distribution, which is a normal distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. How would we do that? Well, let's think. X has a mean of mu. So if we go X minus mu, then this quantity is going to have a mean of 0. And if we divide by sigma, then this whole quantity is going to have a standard deviation of 1. This is a basic linear transformation, and we force this quantity to have a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. And so I'm going to call this z. And if we let z equal x minus mu over sigma, then this random variable z has the standard normal distribution. And so I'm going to write it as SND to save me some writing, or in other words, Z is distributed normally with a mean of 0 and a variance of 1, or equivalently, a standard deviation of 1. Suppose the height of adult American males is approximately normally distributed with a mean of 176.3 centimeters and a standard deviation of 7.1 centimeters. Well, that distribution looks something like this. Normal distribution right here in the middle is the mean and the median, because the mean and median are the same for the normal distribution, and that's 176.3, and we have a standard deviation of 7.1 centimeters. And so we can use this distribution to do some probability calculations. For example, what is the probability a randomly selected adult American male is taller than 180.0 centimeters? Let's let the random variable x represent this height of this randomly selected adult American male, and we want the probability that x takes on a value that is greater than 180.0 centimeters. Well, if we draw out our distribution of heights with 176.3 in the middle, and 180.0 is over here somewhere, and we want the area to the right, that's going to give us the probability that x is greater than 180. Well, let's see. What if I did this? This is equal to the probability x minus mu. I am going to subtract mu and divide by sigma on both sides. I'm allowed to do that. Sigma's positive, so we're dividing by a positive value, so we don't have to worry about anything flipping. This is correct. This is fine. But I also know that z is equal to x minus mu over sigma. And so this is z. So this thing is the probability that z is greater than 180.0, and I'm going to put in the actual value of the mean now, and divide by the standard deviation. And this works out to the probability that z is greater than 0.521. And that is simply the area under our standard normal curve out to the right of 0.521. And we can use a computer or we can use our standard normal table, and I'm going to let you do that and verify for yourselves that this is actually equal to 0.301. What is the probability a randomly selected adult American male has a height between 170.0 and 180.0 centimeters? We want the probability that X lies between 180.0 and 170.0 centimeters. And that is, of course, the area under the curve between 170.0, which is over here somewhere, and 180.0, over there somewhere. That's what we want to find. And we're going to convert this, we're going to standardize this, so we can look it up in a standard normal table if need be. And so I'm going to skip a step here, and I am just going to go straight to subtracting the mean, which is 176.3 centimeters, and dividing by the standard deviation. And now I can call that z, because I am standardizing this. So 180.0 minus 176.3, again, divide by the standard deviation, and we've converted from x to z. So this is the probability that z lies between minus 0.887 and 0.521. And this is our area under our standard normal curve between minus 0.887 and 0.521. That is the probability that we seek. I'm not going to let you throw that into a computer, use the standard normal table to find that that area is 0.511, which means that this probability is 0.511. Here's a different type of problem. What is the 90th percentile of the height of American males? Well, here's my distribution of the height of American males, and here's 176.3 in the middle, and the value of the variable, the value here that yields an area to the left of 0.90 is the 90th percentile. That's what I want to find. So one way we have of doing this is we could say, all right, let's find the 90th percentile for the standard normal distribution. So we'll find the 90th percentile for the standard normal distribution, and to two decimal places, that's 1.28. I'm going to let you verify that for yourselves using a computer or a standard normal table. So the 90th percentile of the standard normal distribution is 1.28. And we also know that Z is equal to X minus mu over sigma, which implies, if we rework that, that x is equal to mu plus sigma z. So if my 90th percentile of the standard normal distribution is 1.28, the 90th percentile of the distribution of x is the mean plus the standard deviation times the 90th percentile of z. This works out to 185.4 centimeters. So the 90th percentile of the height of American males is approximately 185.4 centimeters.